The world's most valuable brands, according to a study by the consultancy agency Brand Finance. In first place, well, you probably maybe could have guessed that one, Apple. The company claimed total global brand supremacy, estimating its worth at $87.3 billion. The South Korean rival Samsung stormed into second place, the brand value jumping a staggering 54% since last year. And it's the only non-US company in the top five. Google is ranked third, about $52 billion. And Microsoft, not surprisingly, comes in fourth place. And the world's largest retailer, which used to be number one in the survey, continues to fall down the list and is now ranked at five. The companies may be the most valuable, but they've all been beaten for the title of the most powerful brand. Well, that has been awarded to Ferrari. Despite making fewer cars than some of its rivals last year, Ferrari gets the most bang for its buck. Higher profits, margins, and customer loyalty pushed it to accelerate to the top spot in terms of powerful brands as opposed to just valuable brands. Brand Finance CEO David Haig told me Samsung's meteoric rise is the big story for the year.
I think the thing which surprised me most was the speed with which Samsung has shot to the top of the table. Last year they were number 13 or 14, this year they're number 2. They really are growing at a rapid rate, and they've always been known to be great functionally. They are now increasingly getting emotional power with consumers.
And in getting to that position, of course, their challenge, but still some way behind Apple, who have had their own, if you like, brand difficulties in the last 12 months.
They are behind Apple, but, you know, the two of them fight it out with each other very closely. You know, if you look at the legal cases over the last year, it's a very strange relationship in that many of the components that go into Apple products come from Samsung, and yet they are locked in a legal battle against one another. And I think if you actually look at the two, it seems very clear that Samsung are rapidly accelerating on product quality. The question is when, if ever, will they overtake them on brand emotion?
The horse meat scandal that's currently bedeviled Europe at the moment, or the meat adulteration scandal, this is a case where not only individual companies could have their brands tarnished, but an industry itself, the brand of an industry, gets tarnished.
Yes, absolutely. And which industry are we talking about? Are we talking about the retail industry or the food manufacturer industry? You could say both have been tarnished to some extent. The interesting thing, I think, is that it creates an opportunity for those brands that are the most open and bounce back and say, look, we're doing it the right way. If you looked at, say, McDonald's a few years ago, they were right on the ropes because they were seen to be secretive, difficult, that they had all sorts of product problems, and they took it to heart and they completely relaunched themselves and revamped themselves, and they've come back.